Memorial Day has come and gone, yet we are a community that strongly values those who commit to serve our country, and thus it is a tradition at these graduation ceremonies that we recognize those students. Some are here with us today, some are at basic training, and others have already completed basic training. Please stand and be recognized. Mallory Beam, Army, at basic training. Ben Brynjolfsson Reardon, Air Force. Austin Persaki, Army. Katie Huseman, Navy. Austin Montgomery, Army. William Roop, National Guard. Liam Smith, ROTC. Gabe Thomas, Marine Corps. Adam Turner, Marine Corps. Brad Williams, National Guard. Would our audience members also please rise if you have served to be recognized with our graduates? Thank you. Every year, when I have to give a graduation speech, I can't fathom what the graduates would actually want to hear me say. Usually by April, they're through listening to pretty much anything I have to say. Understandably so, they are fighting for their independence and ready to move on. The other day, I received a note, though, that put a little more pressure on what I have to say. It's from Emma, who said, "Can't wait to hear your graduation speech, Paganator." Not sure what that means, not going to ask. I also received a very thoughtful and kind note from Emily. She said, "High school is hard, and it's nice to have had cheerleaders." So these are the words that I want you to hear today. You matter. Everyone matters. For those of you who read The Alchemist, and I know some of you have, Paulo Coelho, a Portuguese writer, says it like this: no matter what he or she does, every person on earth plays a central role in the history of our world, and normally they don't know it. But I want you to know it. I want you to feel it. Be the person who shows someone that they matter. And remember, no one matters more than another. We are in this community, this school, this life, together, and we are better together. You know this: soccer, robotics, drama, show choir, band, debate, newspaper, yearbook, friendships, family, church. The list goes on and on. Colleen matters to Rosie. Rosie matters to Colleen. Christian mattered the other day to a whole bunch of young tigers as he walked through their buildings in his graduation gown. Yes, they wanted to know how they could get that tall. It matters that Quinn and Lindsay are dependable, that Abby and Josh may be president. We can only hope. That Alejandra Bonet actively works to support relief efforts in Puerto Rico. That Andrea Whittakin supports people struggling with addiction that she doesn't even know. We show them that they matter. Again, the list goes on and on. You have all done it. So you need to know who are your cheerleaders, and be cheerleaders for others, because everyone matters and deserves a cheerleader. So how can you ensure that every day you actually do that, show that everyone matters? Okay, you've heard this before. Respect, responsibility, integrity, and pride. Respect. Make sure that the choices you make respect yourself first, your friends, your family, your faith, and your finances. Your parents may not pull you out of a bind this time. Dave Willis said, show respect even to people who don't deserve it, not as a reflection of their character, but as a reflection of yours. Everyone matters. Be respectful. Responsibility. Now here's a good quote you should remember. Some of you have tried this already during your high school experience. You cannot talk your way out of a situation you behaved into. This is not to say that you should not take risks. You are going to make mistakes, and we encourage risk-taking. And sometimes, like the author I mentioned earlier, you're going to think, everything tells me I am about to make a wrong decision. But making mistakes is just a part of life. And you're going to think, what does the world want of me? Does it want me to take no risk, to go back to where I came from because I didn't have the courage to say yes to life? Say yes to life. Say yes to everyone matters. Be responsible in your thoughts, your actions, how you treat people, and how you spend your parents' money. Integrity, first and foremost, do not lie to yourself. Have the courage to say no. Have the courage to face the truth. Do the right thing because it's right. And pride. Pride is something that makes you so happy, your heart swells because you love something so much. And many of you have expressed all of this as you've gone through this graduation and senior season. Remember to have that kind of pride. Pride for who you are, where you came from, where you're going, and what you believe. But not the kind of pride that keeps you from saying, I was wrong, and I'm sorry. Today is about all of you. It doesn't matter how you got here. It matters that you found your path, because you matter, because everyone matters. I'll end with a quote from one of the people I follow on Twitter. Be the type of person that no matter where you go or where you are, you always add value to the lives of others around you. Be the difference. Be there. Be kind. Always. Because everyone matters. Dr. Krause, it is an honor to present to you the class of 2018 whose passion, talents, and very, very hard work will continue to matter to the legacy that is Loveland High School.
Now we're cooking with gas.
Here we are.